Hi guys, how is everybody doing? It has been so long since I have recorded a voiceover for my video, but I am back again with another video for you guys. This one is a spring inspired design. I've noticed over the years that flowers are always the popular choice when creating spring designs. So for this particular design, it's actually pretty simple, just some French nails and some partial flowers drawn onto nails with a vertical ombre background. And I pretty much just chose colors that I felt would blend together very nicely. Nothing too technical at all, and this was completely freestyle. Of course, elements of it would have been inspired by what I've already seen out there, but this was completely freestyle. So I hope you guys will enjoy this one. So let's get right into it. So as per usual, you know, I will go through with the preparation of the nails for the service. However, in this case, she has come back for a refill. I believe this might have been 3 weeks, a 3 week grow out. So she's back for a refill, and what I have basically done is just file off the majority of the old design. I don't think you have seen me use this bit before. As you can see, it has a black indicator on the bit, and who can guess what that means? It means the bit is extra coarse. So this bit is used strictly to remove bulk. I do not use this bit on the natural nail at all. I don't use it near the natural nail. So it's strictly used to take down bulk, right? And using this bit at a very high speed can be very effective for removing bulk very quickly. However, it takes a lot of practice, of course, right? So I do not recommend using this bit unless you know what you're doing, because it's only effective if used at an extremely high speed. And when I say high speed, I mean between 15,000 to 20,000 RPMs, right? So it is a panel bit, and I believe I have listed it below in the description box, but I am in absolute love with this bit. It works very well when I am doing my refills or when I'm doing a soak off, right? And like I said, I keep it very far from the natural nail. So once the product starts to thin down, I switch to a bit that has a higher grit, right? So either medium or fine. And of course, you guys already know the golden rule of filing. Do not apply pressure. Well, the golden rules, right? Rules with an S. So you don't apply pressure, one. Two, keep the bit moving. Please do not stay in one place for too long, because as you know, the back and forth motion of the drill will cause heat. If you rub your hands together for too long, you're going to generate heat, right? So that's what friction does. So you don't want to keep the drill in the same place for too long. Move it around, right? Do not apply pressure. Allow the drill to work and take down the nails, right? And hold the finger firmly, support the nail, right? We don't want the drill bit flipping around the nail and possibly causing harm to you or your client, right? So now that I've removed the bulk of the acrylic, I am going to use my sanding band to just remove the remainder of the acrylic that is closer to the natural nail. Well, the gel polish, sorry. Right, and then I'm just going to make the acrylic flush with the natural nail, and at this point I am avoiding the natural nail area altogether because I have not gone in as yet and done my cuticle work. And in hindsight, I guess I could have cleaned up with the cuticles first and then thereafter go in with my sanding band and remove the remainder of the gel polish and then etch the natural nail. So that is what I really should have done, guys, right? So I just added an extra step to the process. So learn from me and don't make that mistake. So the first cuticle bit is the flame bit, and I use this in both forward and reverse. So I do one side, and then I do one side on all 10 nails, and then I switch the direction of the drill and I do the other side. All right, so forward first and then reverse after. Then the next bit that I'm going to use is I need to look back to see what the actual name of this bit is, but it is a, it's not a flame bit, but it's cylindrical with a round top, right? So I use this one on reverse and I am using it to lift the cuticle, right? So I'm lifting the cuticle, and then after that I'm going to go in with my third and the final cuticle bit, and this is it's round but square at the same time. So I forgot to mention that the cylindrical bit with the round top not only helps to lift the cuticle, but it also helps to remove some of the dead cuticle that's on the skin, right? And this is suitable for persons who have very dry cuticles, right? It just falls right off. So by the time I am ready to nip the cuticles, there is not much to lift, if anything at all, right? So as you can see, not much there, just a little tip. Some of them probably didn't even need to be trimmed at all. This particular client, I really don't know what the issue is with her, but she does lift. So I decided to try another primer to see if, you know, that might be the issue. So I'm using a different primer this time around, and I got this primer from my local nail supply store, right? So primed her. Before I primed her, I would have trimmed her cuticles. She didn't have a lot of cuticles to trim, so I didn't spend a lot of time doing that. But after trimming the cuticles, cleansing the nails with my Young Nails Swipe, so this acts as a dehydrator as well to remove all the oils from the nail plates, because you know, if the oils are if there's any hint of oil or grease on the nail plate, that will affect your adhesion. So the Young Nails Swipe was used to dehydrate the nails, cleanse the nails, and then I went in with the primer. So this is just a basic fill. I guess you could probably call it a rebalance as well, because I did take down a lot of product. So it's not just a backfill, but there's a significant amount of product that is added throughout the body of the nail, just to ensure that the proper structure is maintained. So I'm going in and I am doing my fill. So for those of you who have been watching my channel since last year, I would really love for you guys to comment below and let me know what you think about my application from then until now. I am trying my very best to use the minimum amount of beads as possible because I do know that that will help me to improve on my speed. But damn, I must say that it is very difficult. It is very difficult, but you know, I am not giving up because I do know that with practice in time, I will get it. So let me know what you guys think. And also, if you are a nail tech or if you are a nail enthusiast, let me know what your application process is like. Do you use small beads? Do you use multiple beads? Do you use one bead to build the nail? Do you use two? Do you use three? Do you apply the acrylic and then do patchwork afterwards? Let me know. This client is a lifter. Like, I have been, you know, experimenting, trying different things with her to minimize the lifting. And as you can see, when she came back this time around, she did not have any lifting on her left hand. And I was so happy about that because for her, it's usually her pointer finger and her middle fingers that lift on both hands. But I had changed up my process, spent more time cleaning up the cuticle area. So I'm going to do the same thing this time around and hope that moving forward, she will have absolutely no lifting. There was lifting on her right hand. However, if you notice, guys, I usually show you guys the left hand, and that's because of how my camera is positioned. Most times when I am filming, the right hand is out of frame completely. So that is why I wasn't able to include the footage for the right hand. But she did have lifting on the right hand, and I had to remove the nails that were lifting and reform them. Alright, so after I have applied the acrylic, I shape and file the nails, and I will not bore you guys with that. So we're going to skip along and move on to the artwork. Alright, so before I go in with the nail art, I am going to coat the nail with a layer of Young Nails protein bond, and this is just to help with the adhesion of the gel polish, and it also helps to fill all those little scratches that were left behind by the nail file. I could have gone in and buffed it smooth, but I prefer to use the protein bond because I believe that, you know, it's a faster process, one, and two, I think the gel stands a better chance of adhering. Well, I don't think, I know that the gel stands a better chance of adhering to the acrylic once there is a little texture on the surface. So I don't want to go in and get rid of that completely. I need the texture to ensure that the gel will stick and hold onto the nail as best as possible. So as I said before, it is a very simple design. I just go in with my black liner, and the gel polish that I'm using, the black gel polish, is actually from Young Nails as well. I absolutely love using this black. It is very pigmented and it's very thick and nice, so it allows you to create very crisp and sharp lines, right? Because as you know, when you're doing nail art, the thicker the polish is the more control you will have over the brush, right? So when you're buying your gel polishes for art, for line work, that is definitely something that you have to look out for, right? You can't use the polishes that have a very thin consistency. The only time you would use those is if you're using it to polish the nail in entirety, or if you're using it for shading. And even so, you still want it to be pigmented, because you don't want there to be a requirement for you to go in a second time, right? So in addition to the French, I am also doing a vertical ombre, right? And not sure if you guys would have seen the little short that I posted some time ago demonstrating how to do the vertical ombre. So if you haven't seen it, you can check that out, because I really did explain in detail how you can achieve it. But it's very, very simple. Just start with the lighter color, sprinkle some clear acrylic on top, and then cure. When that's out of the light, you brush off the excess clear acrylic. And the reason why I add the clear acrylic is because it just allows the blend between the two colors to be very seamless and flush and nice, right? So that's a little hack, right? For the index finger, you'll see me there removing the French line that I created. I didn't like it. It was looking a little off, so I just used some, I think I used either alcohol or swipe to clean it off. And I, instead of wasting time and waiting on it to dry, I just went ahead and dusted the two nails with the clear acrylic. And then once it was dry, I went back in with the protein bond again. And then I'm gonna proceed to redo the French line. Right, so you're seeing firsthand, guys, I made a mistake and I'm gonna fix it. And this happens all the time in the salon, all the time. Like, no matter how much of an expert you are at nails, you are not immune to making mistakes, right? What I can say though is that perhaps the more advanced you are, is the less mistakes you will make, right? But we do make mistakes from time to time, and that's perfectly fine. Just go back in, take care of it, do what you have to do to fix it, and move right along. All right, so I will put that hand to cure and then move on to the next hand. All right, and then once that's cure, I'm going to complete the vertical ombre. So this is the second stage of the vertical ombre, right? So now I'm gonna add both colors on either side, and then I'm going to use my ombre brush to blend the two colors together in the middle. Okay guys, so in case you're wondering how I chose the colors, right, I am not good at color theory or anything like that, right? I'm still learning, I'm trying to understand how to mix and match colors. But In this case, what I really did was I just thought about it and I said, okay, which colors, right, will blend together really nicely to make a third color, right, in the middle. So I know that red and yellow makes orange, right, and I know that blue and red makes purple. So I'm obviously not using red, but I'm using pink, right? So I figured that since red and yellow would mix together to make orange, then pink and yellow, right, and the pink and the bluish purple, it looks more like purple, but I figured that those colors would also mix together to create some kind of variation of orange and purple, right? So that is what I decided. And I also said, okay, if I want to use one color on both nails, so that one color that I decided to use was the pink, right? So that's all there is to it. I mean, I did it and I liked how it turned out, and it's as simple as that, right? So don't feel alone if you struggle finding inspiration and if you struggle with doing freestyle nails, because I do too. I really struggle with doing freestyle, but I am trying my best to warm up to it, and I am challenging myself to do more freestyle sets. So just cleaning up, and then I will let her cure, and then we will move on to drawing the flowers. All right, so I also decided to go ahead and add a little sparkle to the background. I really thought that would bring the look off very nicely. And now that I look back at the video, I'm actually thinking that I could have added a second French line using a sparkly color as well. Not that one, because as you can see, that one is very thin, but I do have something. I do have a striper that is similar to that. So I could have used that and created a second French line on the black, and I really think that would have made this design pop a little bit more, but I still think it turned out very nicely, if you ask me. So I think this was my favorite part of creating this design, doing the flowers, and they are partial flowers, so they are basically just sitting at the edge of the nail. So pretty simple, just use a dotting tool to create the, I guess that would be the tip of the petals, right? And then you will use your striper brush to converge the lines to an imaginary center, right? So I pull the lines down to that imaginary center first, and then thereafter I will fill in the petals to the desired shape that I want. So just adding my final touches to the flowers, and I'm creating a little center there, and I decided to use orange for the pink and yellow nail, and then yellow for the pink and purple nail. Not very visible, but they are there. So that is it. Of course, I'm going to do the thumb separately. As you guys know, I always do my thumbs separately, and if I try to do it otherwise, I always end up regretting, right? In most cases, I will have to redo the thumbs and I waste a lot of time. So just to be on the safe side, I prefer to do the thumbs separately. But if you guys know of any lamp out there that can enable me to do all five nails and cure the thumbs properly, please make a recommendation, because I definitely would want to purchase any such lamp, right? Because it would save me so much time, right? So if you know of any such light, please make a recommendation. I would really appreciate it.
So there you have it, guys. Here is the final look.
would you try this design? I think it turned out so cute, absolutely cute, 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 Kia done. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.